are back with Chef Mario Batali. There is nothing like a hot grilled cheese sandwich on a cold day. It is the epitome of comfort food, but wait till you see Mario's version. Mario, first of all, I must say, this does not look like my grilled cheese. What are we making here? This is not the traditional.
Well, this is something that if it was said in Italian would be pomodoro e ricotta in carrozza.
Oh, that sounds so sexy.
Which is a grilled cheese and tomato sandwich.
Oh, is that what?
Exactly. But the in carrozza refers to the carriage, which is kind of like the French bread dipping that we're going to put the sandwich in.
Okay, so let's see what you do.
So, all right, so we're going to take some ricotta. Ooh. And this is just a nice soft cheese. You could use anything that you wanted,
even cream
cheese.
That's just dry bread. Nothing
right, else. Just dry bread. A little pinch of malted salt. You want to take some tomatoes. Now, I know it's the end of tomato season, so if you were thinking about it, go ahead and put them on.
Right,
a couple of nice pieces.
Okay. Couple?
Yeah, okay. Well, no, one nice thick one, just like that.
Okay.
You're right.
Okay.
But if it was that tomatoes had already gone from your town, then you might want to think about using something else that's coming into season, which is acorn squash. So
oh,
what we
you're
did
kidding.
Is we took a couple of slices and baked them in a quick oven so they're just softened through.
Okay.
Put a couple of those on. We sprinkle them. You
what
want to hit them with
salt?
A little salt? This is Maldon salt. It's an English sea salt.
Do you need that? Because where are you going to find that?
Oh, you can find it at the grocery store,
really?
Online or in fancy grocery stores all over the country.
All right.
Then we're going to go like so, Mom. Right? Now I have eggs and milk. Give it another pound.
Yeah, there you go.
You can't be too tender
no,
with
can't.
Your food. So this is just like
a boss, is what I said.
That's right, exactly. You're showing it. Not that that bread didn't know you were the boss already, because it had sensed that you had orange Crocs on, even from on top of the table.
Yes, I do.
Yes,
right
you
there.
Do. So okay. Then we press it in like
oh,
that.
Oh, there you go.
Then you press it in like so. Now hold on, a little extra virgin
see, I
olive
normally
oil.
Just put some butter in the pan. This
well,
is
we're going to do both because we're a fan of the lipids of
look
choice.
Look at the way you do it. You just so put the, your hand right in.
Right, exactly.
Okay.
So now what that'll do, the oil would cause it to cook and get delicious flavor, but what the butter will do will give it a hazelnut flavor, kind of a toasted nut taste, and also cause it to brown a little bit more quickly and a little bit more easily.
So then just dump it in, okay.
Now keep in mind, you say dump, but I know what you meant is gently,
gently
ply
yes,
it
yes.
with loving attention.
But now
put it in there.
I normally would press down with a spatula. Do you do that? Oh, ah!
Press on, you crazy diamond. Now, you don't want to press it too hard,
why?
Right? Well, all right, press it as hard as you normally would.
I press it like that. I get up and
so,
I press it.
So, I sense that perhaps there was a baker in your past that didn't listen to you. Is that what you're suggesting?
I got some
because
anger issues.
You're
is that enough time?
It around. Well, you tell me. What do you think?
I think so.
Well, all right, now let's hold on. Give it a flip.
Oh. Oh, no, it wasn't quite ready.
You know what? That's all right. We're going to do it on both sides. So, we'll
okay.
cook it like that.
Okay.
And then we're going to start with this other one like this. So, this is the tomato
can
one.
Can I do that?
Yes, you can. Okay. Hold on, are you gonna mishandle it?
No, no, no.
Are you gonna
I
abuse
never.
That poor little sandwich?
I'm rubbing it gently.
You're rubbing it gently?
Yes.
Now you're gonna give it a little press while it's in there.
Oh, I should have done that with
yes,
my hand.
Yes, you should have.
Okay. All right.
Ready? And now you're ready to airlift it in, or you want me to take care
no,
of it?
No, you take care of that.
All right, hold on, now watch. See, now I don't beat on it, I just.
Gentle loving. Okay, very nice. Okay,
because
can
you
we.
You see, it will come out like you want it to. So now we got this one here. And it's cooking a little bit more slowly than I'd hoped.
Yeah, okay. Well,
and that's
we have
all right.
a finished
we
one, don't we?
We have a perfect one. We're going to cook these until they're right, which I was going to say is about 3.5 to 4 minutes on the side.
On each
and
side?
On each side.
Okay.
Then what we do is we take it out like so. I put a little bit more pepper, particularly on tomatoes, because I think tomatoes with a little bit of pepper remind me of going to college in New Jersey. For us.
Well, how, I don't get that connection.
Because the Jersey is the Garden State, and the Jersey tomatoes are some of the
oh,
most delicious of all.
Okay.
So then I'm going to sprinkle it with just a little bit of that. Let's take a taste. Ready?
Mmm. Oh, oh, mmm.
Don't you just want to kiss me?
Mmm.
Mm. I mean, I came knowing I wanted to kiss
you. Oh, baby,
you.
This is so good.